I've made 21 studio albums. This is what happens if you don't die. Well, that's not counting some compilation records that they made because they thought I was gonna die. I mean, I'm gonna, but not on their schedule. Those 21 albums, there are only four that aren't composed entirely of songs that I wrote. That's kind of how I justify the space I take up on the planet, is I kind of write songs. I couldn't imagine that. Then 20 years ago, I found it necessary to make a record of Townes Van Zandt songs. Guy Clark passed away, and I felt obligated to make that record because I don't want to be haunted by either one of those motherfuckers. And then 4 years ago, we lost Jerry Jeff Walker, and that was it. That was the last of my four original teachers. I was very, very lucky. Jerry Jeff Walker was born in Oneonta, New York. Drifted down to Greenwich Village and was pretty young. Became part of a third wave of folk singers down there. And he was the featured performer on the National College Coffee House circuit by the late 60s. Traveled all over the country, all over North America. Mostly by thumb, sleeping on people's couches. Well, sometimes he didn't sleep on the couch. Let's just say that at that point in his life, Jerry Jeff was opposed to paying for either transportation or accommodation. His travels brought him to Houston, Texas on a regular basis, where he became friends for life with Guy Clark and Townes Van Zandt. This song was written when he was crashing on Townes' couch in an apartment above a coffee house called the Sand Mountain in Houston. It's a parking lot now. And sometimes he'd play the Good Woman Coffee House at Vanderbilt University of Nashville, Tennessee. And he was there playing around the time this song was making a lot of noise. And Billboard magazine sent a young man out to interview him. That young man's name was Jimmy Buffett. That was his day job at the time. And they hit it off. They finished the interview, and Buffett said, "Well, I got some songs." They sat up passing the guitar back and forth all night long. And then they ran out of gas, and Buffett took Jerry Jeff home with him, and he always swore that was the last nail in the coffin of his first marriage. And then Jerry Jeff eventually drifted down to Coconut Grove in Miami, Florida. He followed his teacher, Fred Neal. Freddie Neal wrote, "Everybody's talking at me," and a bunch of other great songs. And Buffett shows up after a while, a month early for a gig. He had his calendar all fucked up. And they're trying to figure out what to do with themselves, and Jerry Jeff says, "I know." Jerry Jeff Walker drove Jimmy Buffett to Key West for the first time in his life in a 1947 Packard, and the rest is history. Then Jerry Jeff got kicked out of Key West. How the fuck do you do that? And he settled in Austin, Texas, where he lived for the rest of his life and raised a family and he's buried in the Texas State Cemetery. I had the honor of being asked to sing my own man at Jerry Jeff's graveside. That's the last time I saw Buffett. And I took the opportunity that day to get Susan and Jacko and Jesse's blessing so I could make a record of Jerry Jeff Walker songs. Now, I know all these songs by heart because I wanted to be Jerry Jeff Walker more than anything else in the world at one point in my life. This song I learned for a play that we did during my short career in high school. I've been singing it since I was 14 years old. I became famous for this song in my high school, and it didn't scare 14-year-old girls, so I sang it all the time. Until I was not quite 18, I met Jerry Jeff Walker and I had to quit singing. That's my favorite thing about this project is I get to sing this song again. And you know what? You can sing it too. And I could use the help.
Travel the land, He shook his head as he shook his head. Someone asked him, please.
If the boy